Hello, and welcome to video 2 of module 4, using the LeastSquares regression line. In this video, we'll touch briefly on what the LeastSquares regression line is, but we'll mostly be using it to make a couple of predictions for some data. So let's get started. When data are approximately linearly correlated, we can form the LeastSquares regression line. So what is this LeastSquares regression line? Well, it's a line that's given in this form, y hat equals mx plus c. Now, you might think this sounds a little similar to y equals mx plus b, and that's because it is. I'm basically just using a c instead of b, and I'm using a y hat instead of just a y. This is the traditional form of this line, although sometimes different letters are used other than m and c. I'm choosing to use these letters here because my students in my classes have different types of calculators, and different calculators use different letters, so I'm trying to avoid as much confusion as possible, so that's why I've chosen to use these variables here. When I'm choosing these variables, I'm using m to represent the slope of the line, and c to represent the y-intercept of the line. We're going to delve much deeper into what exactly slope and y-intercept mean in a future video, but for right now, we can just know that these are components to the line. I'll also mention that the least squares regression line is traditionally given with that little triangular thing over the y, but it doesn't have to be. So let's see why. That little triangular thing is called a hat, and usually it's going to go over the variable that we're predicting. So sometimes you might know a value for x, and you need to use that to predict y. That's the normal case, so that's why the hat is usually over the y. Usually you're going to know an x value and then use it to predict the y value, so the y wears the hat. But sometimes the line can be used in a different way. Sometimes you might actually know the y value and have to predict what the x value is. So in that case, the hat is going to move to the x, so we would see y equals mx hat plus c. So you don't want to think of the hat so much as attached to the y, as like part of the y, like subscripts could be, but it's a piece that moves. It's a hat. It can move from person to person. It can move from letter to letter. So it's worn by the letter that we're making a prediction about. So let's do a couple of examples where we make some predictions. Alright, so I have to apologize. Between the previous slide and this one, my neighbor has decided it's a good time to mow his lawn, so I apologize if you can hear the lawnmower in the background. Not a thing I have any control over right now. So throughout these Module 4 videos, we are looking at an example of data collected by Harriet concerning the displacement volume of an engine and its combined city and highway mileage. In a previous video, we determined that the displacement volume was the independent variable, meaning it gets to be x, and the combined mileage is the dependent variable, meaning it gets to be y. We're going to need this information as we move forward in the following examples. Okay, just so we keep it as a reminder, I'm going to write at the top of the screen that x is still representing our displacement volume, which is measured in liters, and y is representing our gas mileage, which is measured in miles per gallon. Now, Harriet has used some form of technology or some different formulas to determine her equation of the least squares regression line. So she's got this equation, y hat equals 34.103 minus 2.804x. We're going to use this equation to answer a couple of questions. So for part A, the 2017 Toyota Camry has a 4-cylinder 2.5-liter engine. We're going to use the least squares regression line to estimate the Camry's combined gas mileage, and we're told specifically not to round our answer. Now, when I pull out the relevant information from this paragraph here, the important part is that the Camry has a 2.5-liter engine. This is telling us the displacement volume of the engine. Since we've been told the displacement volume, that's going to be a value for x, since x represents displacement volume. So when I use the equation of the least squares regression line, I'm going to substitute 2.5 in for x. So I have y hat equals 34.103 minus 2.804 times 2.5. Notice that when we substitute into the equation, all I have are numbers on the right-hand side. So this is a pretty easy one. I just have to type these numbers into a calculator to get my answer. So I went ahead and did that, and I got 27.093. So y hat is 27.093. Because we were told specifically not to round our answer, we're not going to round it, but we do need to make sure we label it. Since y is gas mileage, and gas mileage is measured in miles per gallon, or mpg, I'm going to write my final answer as 27.093 mpg. When I give my answer, the y is still wearing a hat because this is a number we predicted for an x value of 2.5 liters. Let's do another example of using this least squares regression line. The 2017 Chrysler 300 has a combined gas mileage of 23 miles per gallon. We're going to use the least squares regression line to estimate the Chrysler's displacement volume to the nearest tenth. For this example, the relevant information that we've been given is the 23 miles per gallon. This is telling us a gas mileage. In other words, this is telling us a value for y. So this time, we know the value that y is going to take on, so we're going to be predicting the x. So when I substitute into the equation, I'm going to move the hat from the y over to the x. So I substitute 23 in for y, and now notice that the x is wearing a hat on the right-hand side of the equation. Also, unfortunately, this time, I can't just type it all into a calculator and get my answer, because I have numbers on both sides of the equation, so I'm going to have to solve this equation for x. To do so, we're going to start by subtracting 34.103 from both sides of the equation. This is because on the right-hand side, 34.103 minus 34.103 is going to give me 0, so it cancels out, and I'll just be left with the portion that has the x. So on the left-hand side, I'm going to do 23 minus 34.103, and that's going to give me a negative 11.103. On the right-hand side, that portion that has the x is just going to come down. Notice that because in the original equation we were subtracting 2.804x hat, when I bring it down, it becomes a negative 2.804x hat. So I need to bring that subtraction down as a negative sign. To finish off, because the negative 2.804 is being multiplied to the x hat, in order to undo the multiplication, we're going to divide. So I'm going to divide both sides by negative 2.804. This is because on the right-hand side now, the negative 2.804s are going to cancel out and give me 1, so I just end up with 1x hat on the right. And on the left-hand side, I ended up getting 3.9597 when I did the division. So, in this problem, we were told to round our answer to the nearest tenth. So the first 9 is in the tenths place, and because there's a 5 just to the right of it, it means it's going to round up. So 3.9597 is going to round up to 4.0. So x hat is 4.0 liters. In other words, the Chrysler, which had a gas mileage of 23 miles per gallon, was used to predict that the Chrysler will have a displacement volume of 4 liters. All right, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we'll talk about residuals, which are a way of exploring how accurate the predictions are when compared to the actual data set. So thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.